virtual class of Municipal Corporation of Greater Mumbai Education Department. I am Mrs. Akshada Kale and today we will learn maths. Okay, now we will move to the chapter. Welcome to Virtual Training Center Dadav. I am Akshata Kale and today we will learn maths of standard 3rd and the topic is multiplication. Yes, dear students, there are 4 types of operations are there in mathematics: addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. Correct? Whenever we are in need of the total of 2 to 3 numbers, then we go for addition, isn't it? And whenever we are in need of the difference between 2 or more numbers, we use subtraction. Correct? Okay, then today we will learn about multiplication. Yes, dear students, see this. This is the sign of multiplication. Okay? Yes, today is Teacher's Day. Okay? There are 5 students. They want to give a bouquet for the teacher. So, they all of them brought 2 flowers. Now, Ravi, Raju, Gopu, Sonu and Meena, they all together they brought how many flowers we will see. Now, Gopu is going to collect all the flowers and he is going to make a bouquet to give it to the teacher. Yes, we will see how many flowers are there in that bouquet. Okay, now see here, each child bought 2 flowers. Means, see, Ravi bought 2, Raju bought 2 flowers, Gopu 2 flowers and Sunu also bought 2 flowers and Meena too bought 2 flowers. Means here 2 plus 2 plus 2 plus 2 plus 2 is 10, isn't it? Means you can say that 10 flowers are there in the bouquet. Now see how many times 2 is there. We will see. This is 1 time, that is Ravi's. 2 time, 3 time, 4 time, 5 time. Means here 5 times we have written 2, isn't it? So we can go for one more method which is very quick compared to this addition method. See, this is 2 times 5, correct? So it is 5 2s are 10, isn't it? Means there are 10 flowers are there in the bouquet and that they gave to their teacher. For the students, here we added 2 5 times, then we got 10. In another method, what we did, 2 we have multiplied by 5 and we got 10. The second method is called as multiplication method. Yes, here 4 lemons are there. In one row, 4 lemons are there. Yes, one more row is there. Means, in one row 4 lemons and the second row also has 4 lemons. Means, 4 plus 4 is equal to 8. You know that, correct? In one more method, in multiplication method, how we will do? 4, how many rows are there? 2 rows. So, we will multiply 4 into 2, that is 8 lemons are there all together. We can see here a mangoes in the basket. Yes, there are 6 mangoes are there in one basket. See, here 3 baskets are there with 6 mangoes in each. Okay, what is the total number of mangoes? We have to calculate. Then what we do? 6 plus 6 plus 6. Isn't it? That is equal to 18. Correct? No, this is the addition method. We added 3 times 6. Same method. We will follow the multiplication. Here 6. How many times? 3 times. Correct? Because 3 baskets are there. So, 6 multiplied by 3 is equal to 18. 18 is called as the product. Now here answer we got 18, isn't it? That is called as product. Okay. You can see here cucumbers, correct? Now we will count them. See, in the first row there are 4 cucumbers. Second row, 4 cucumbers. Third row, there are 4. And in the fourth row also, there are 4 cucumbers. Now, what is the total? In addition method, what we do? 4 plus 4 plus 4 plus 4. Isn't it? 4 times we add 4. So, we get 16. Means there are 16 cucumbers all together. Okay, in the second method, what we will do? 4 times 4. So 4 multiplied by 4. That is equal to 16. Isn't it? Same answer we will get by addition and also by multiplication. Okay. Now we can see mangoes here. Again 4 mangoes in a row. 4 more, second row, third row, fourth row, fifth row, sixth row, seventh row, eighth row, and ninth row. Means there are 9 rows are there and each row has 4 mangoes. Means we will add 4 9 times. Isn't it? See this. 9 times we added 4, so we get the answer 36. So there are 36 mangoes are there all together, isn't it? Now in the second method, that is in the multiplication method, what we do? 4 into 9 rows. So 4 nines are is equal to 36. So how many total mangoes are there? 36 mangoes are there. Got this, students? The second method, that is multiplication method, is very easy compared to the addition method. Multiplication. Yes, dear students, see, this is a bundle of sugar cane. Okay? Second bundle. Third bundle and fourth bundle, isn't it? And each bundle has 10 sugar canes. Got this? In one bundle, there are 10 sugar canes. Then we want to calculate how many sugar canes are there in 4 bundles. Okay, what we will do? We will add 10 plus 10 plus 10 plus 10. Means, how many times 10 we have written? Yes, correct. We have written 4 times 10. Isn't it? Now, in other words, 10 multiplied by 4 is equal to 40. Isn't it? Means what we can say here? There are total 40 sugar canes are there in 4 bundles. Okay? Now again here, 8 apples in each box. boxes are there, and in each box how many apples are there? 8 apples. How many apples in 3 such boxes? Okay, one box has 8 apples. Okay, see here, means what we will do? 8 plus 8 plus 8, isn't it? Means how many times 8? 3 times 8, correct? Now in other word, how we will write? 8 threes are 24. 8 we have counted 3 times, that is nothing but 24, isn't it? See here, if you want to count, you count. In the first box 8, in the second box again 8, that is 16, plus 8, that is 24 apples are there in 3 boxes. Like this we have to write. Hence 3 boxes have 24 apples together. Okay, 6 balls in each box. See there, 6 balls are there in one box. How many balls in 7 boxes? Okay, same type of 7 boxes are there. We have to count total how many balls are there in 7 boxes. So, how we will write? 6 balls in each box means 6 we will write 7 times, isn't it? Means 7 times 6. I hope you understand each step, correct? Okay, in other words, we will write 6 multiplied by 7 is equal to 42. Means there are total 42 balls are there in 7 boxes. Correct? Now here, children are standing in 5 groups of 4 children each. Means, groups are there of children, and in each group, 4 children are standing together. How many groups are there? 5 groups are there. Okay, then how you will calculate? 4 dash times 4 means here, how many groups are there? 5. So, 5 times 4. Isn't it? 5 fours are how much? 20. Is it right? 20. Correct? Now, in other words, 4 multiplied by how many groups are there? 5 groups are there. So, 4 fives are 20. See here. Altogether 20 students are there. If you want to count, count them. Now, how we will write the answer? Hence, altogether there are 20 children. Because 5 groups are there and the total number of children are 20. Now here, one notebook costs rupees 8. The cost of this notebook is rupees 8. How much will 8 such notebooks cost? What is the cost of one notebook? Rupees 8. Then what is the cost of 8 notebooks? We have to find out. Here, see here, an addition of 8 taken 8 times, isn't it? One book costs rupees 8, then what is the cost of 8 books? So, 8 multiplied by 8 we are going to do. Right? Now, here, therefore, 8 multiplied by 8 is equal to 64. So, dear students, the cost of 8 notebooks is rupees 64. Yes, thank you students. Now, tables are necessary to carry out multiplications, right? So, dear students, recite the tables up to 5 and 10 times table. In the next lecture, we will proceed to single digit multiplications and will also learn making tables. Okay? Take care of yourself and bye-bye. Thank you very much students for being a part of this lesson. Please subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon to get new updated videos.